Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Ravenloft Stone Prophet. In today's episode, we are going to probably start our exploration of the Obelisk. However, first... I actually recorded this twice, just because I wanted to get out of things way. We have some stuff we're going to do in here. I've done a little bit of playing while we weren't, like, off-screen. And first, I have... Let's see, where is it? Blackhand, a friend of mine, he let me know that there was a button here, and I did press it, and it turns off the spinner back here. I also found out that our troll companion's armored claws do not hurt things that require magic weapons, so we're going to be replacing him with the undead paladin, which is through a secret door right here, and then there's another secret door right here. So we're going to go get her right away. Yeah. See? Doesn't hurt it. Useless troll. Okay, and here she is.
What creature are you? For by the gods, no willpower would look in these unholy depths. No villager, rather.
Men haunt their hovels, the beasts their lairs. These chill walls call to me. Home, they whisper softly. You are home. Who am I to argue with walls? And if I am to be cursed, what matters the location? If you must have a logic to my appearance here, it is this. I have no need to frighten the villagers of Muhar. Their lives are curse enough.
Perhaps to be in Harakir at all is to be cursed. In what case we share your fate? What special nature is the curse you bear?
A coarse fate. To awaken from death with a curse such as this. Undead, I shall remain until I gain vengeance on he who put me in this state. I cannot finally, fully die until the deed is done. Special nature, you ask. Is this fate of mine not special? Does it not warrant the contempt in which I hold it? I met death bravely. Yes, even I will say it, as a champion. For who would see such goodness in my eyes today?
Swell being a dick again.
A curse indeed, from champion to the ranks of the wretched undead. How might we avoid this fate?
Harakir decides the fate of those within her borders. Still, if you would fare better, avoid Sennet. They were his fierce eyes last looked into mine. That tattered soul, wrapped in mummy's garb, took me into his clutches and then... When I awoke... Well, what remains of the fighter I was stands before you. My hero's heart lies stilled within this corrupt flesh.
Sennet, what creature in Harakir bears this name?
Sennet is no creature, except in his heart, his eyes, and the evil which lurks in every sinew of his being. Once a child of Agdapot, Sennet turned against the lord who made him. That is, he conspired with the priestess of Set. Together they planned to rule in place of Agdapot, so the story is told. It is a tale I would end if I could. Free myself from the bonds of this undead decay by destroying Sennet.
You appear capable enough to these eyes, why have you not Oh, that's Goldleaf.
You appear capable enough to these eyes, why have you not sought your vengeance upon the evil Sennet?
If only I had the power! Formidable I may be, and fear I know nothing of. Yet I know my limitations. The energy of Sennet cannot be crushed to blackness by me alone. Oh, what a vision! The righteous destruction of Sennet. It would end my misery, free my soul from this revenant guise. If I could reach out and grasp such a prize.
Let's see.
If you prove as fierce in battle as with words, you shall make a valuable partner. Will you join with us as you once did? We too may chance upon Sennet.
If any chance remains that I may once again meet Sennet, I shall join you. Together we shall tear that fiend down from his dreams of power. We shall rend his mummy's wrap, tearing both it and he to the same small bits. But know you this, my armor and my sword, they stay with me no matter the cause, even if I die. It is the one small pleasure of being undead. Our pockets are rarely picked.
Okay, and we are replacing the troll.
Ungrug, go back. Go hide in desert. No one want Ungrug. No one ever want him.
Daw. No matter, though. We killed the guy that beat the hell out of him, so he should be okay. Alright, and now we have Glorinthia, the undead paladin. She's 8th level, so she's on par with Swell there. Swell is probably the better paladin. Because her dex isn't high enough, I don't think, to pop her up any AC or anything. See, she's got plate mail and a two-handed sword. And a crap ton of water. I don't know if she even needs to drink. Yeah, apparently not. Oh, that's from the troll. We're actually going to drop that. We'll keep a row of them, just in case. But, as a rule, we don't need it. Okay, so we have filled out the party now. And she should be able to lay, yes. Sweet! So we find any, gauntlets of ogre power or anything. She's probably going to be picking them up, because her strength is kind of low by comparison. See, then this water skin. I didn't check down this way, so I just know that there's a secret door there. A battle axe, damn it. Inventory. Not magical. More powder of coagulation. I still don't know what that does. A adamantite helm that I can't tell is magical or not. And some adamantite plate mail. Oh, hell yeah. Make her look all badass and everything. Non-magical shield, don't care. And a water skin. I think... Yeah, we'll give her plate to... Because gold leaf needs to be at negative one. Now we'll give her the adamantite plate mail. The chain, we'll get rid of. Plate helm, give to gold leaf, and I think that's good. What's her carrying capacity? 69. Alright, she's good. Okay, we have a hole, and an obvious button that smells of trap, so we're gonna save. Oh, okay. That was easy. Oh god. Go, clicky button, go! Yeah! Okay. I knew I saw a goodie down here. See, cure serious, raise dead, cure critical, drop the heal spell in there. Alright. Alright, where did the grave elemental spawn in it. Ah, there it is. Alright. I'm coming, hold your horses. Ow. Oh my god! Grave Elemental, why you gotta hit so hard? Does she have any good heals? No. In that case, damn it. Potion! See, if I had a magic user, I'd be magic missiling the thing across the table. Darn it. Still can take a hit. Sleep. Yes. And save again. Because we're cowards. Oh my god! Ooh, good hit, Racked here. Ooh, good hit, Grave Elemental, too. God damn it, Gold Leaf. Flame Blade. Yeah! The two back row people just wasted that thing. Can't use it. A potion of flying, ooh. If this were Menzo Barons, then we'd have already found like 50 of those things. Darn it. There you go. Okay. Well, we found a new area. That counts for something. Got some extra XPs. And we were right in the way of that lightning bolt trap. Okay. So we are done here in this area of the world. So save. And let's go hit up that obelisk. Now, I don't... I don't remember anything from that obelisk. I don't think I ever got that far when I played earlier. Like, when I was younger. So this should be an adventure. I'm gonna check how people are doing on XP here real quick. Nobody's near leveling. God, she is a long ways away from leveling. Nobody's near leveling. If we were, I'd have probably stayed out here and killed off what remains of the trolls. But as it stands, I'm not gonna get anything out of it. I mean, I'll get a little bit closer to leveling, yeah. But I don't think that's worth sitting out here for 15 minutes and killing them one at a time. So instead, we go to the other area. Okay, give me the map. Alright. The slow-scrolling map of failure. Okay, I know that it's, like, to the southwest-ish. So we'll go to the southwest for a while, and then I'll check my map. Let's see, from here we'll go straight south. Okay, here's the ruins. There's the Wemmick. And there is it. Okay. In we go. Whoa. That doesn't bode well. Devil Green Lightning! Okay. I suppose we could talk to this thing.
A heartbeat. A breath. The sounds of life enter these empty halls. I greet you. My thoughts have scratched and turned within this place. Empty and alone now for so long. The only sound has been the sigh of the storms, beating against the outer walls. Ah, so wonderful, the scent of mortal flesh. You have come, as the prophecy foretold.
Ghostly creature, be on your guard. Of what interest is the scent of our flesh?
Oh, no harm, no harm to my offer. The stones are cold, the dust dry. The aura of mortal flesh awakens me, reminds me how long it has been since I became guardian of the stone prophet. It has been my charge to await a time when mortals would approach these stones and attempt to understand them. In obedience to that mission, I speak. After that, I shall forever fade away.
Okay. You speak of the stones. These strange markings at your back. Might you read them for us?
Mortal arrogance! With what ease do you expect the fate to prepare your path? It shall not be, for my work is my work, and the knowledge you seek is not mine to give. The writings of the prophet reach back, far, far back, into a dawn we cannot know. Gentle rains have worn mountains down, and streams have turned to seas since the days of the prophecy. And age and an age and an age has passed, years enough to count each grain of sand in the deserts of Harakim.
Perhaps the writings on the stone are why we have been led to this place. How might these writings be understood?
You have come far, and so you must understand this. Courage and daring alone might reveal the secret of the stone prophet. By this I mean that you must travel deep within the obelisk and search them out, these secrets. Three levels rest within, each more difficult than the last. That you have come this far means you have the power to fulfill the prophecy. But be warned, having the power to do something and being destined to do it are different things.
These stones, do they speak of Octopot?
The fate of Harakir does not rest with Octopot alone. True, his role is great, his power frightening to behold. Yet all is not as it seems. A great responsibility has imposed itself upon you, for all those trapped within Harakir suffer. Their fate and yours are bound together, linked by the chains of fate. Only as you succeed might they live. Only in obeying the words of the Stone Prophet might you survive and, in time, return to your beloved homeland.
Okay. And do the stones reveal the history of this land of Harakir?
The Stone Prophet concerns itself with the end of things, not with their beginnings. Know you not the age of this land? What wall might hold such history? Mountains would cower before it. The sky might break against its heights. Were I to recount the tale of Harakir, no mortal lifetime could stretch from my first words to my last.
One last question before we part. The blind seer who led us to this place, will she make her way safely home?
Worry not, for that one has served her purpose. You have yet to do as much. Yes, she shall return safely to her home, and more than that, I shall not say. Fare you well in the way ahead. Though the fate of Harakir rests with you, I shall not know the outcome. Having honored my charge to stand as ward and await your arrival, I go now to my rest. Never again.
Okay, never again shall his voice be heard within these ancient walls. Alright, and it looks like we're going down. We shall save so that I do not have to go through that again, and I think we're gonna rest. Okay. I should have probably cast her Flame Blade. And, yeah. Okay. And we're gonna drop a prayer. Because I do not know what awaits us in here. Some Kiok Tom's ointment. Do I have a bag full of that? Yes. Of course. Flame arrow, and ooh, the obelisk teleport key. They need to give us a bag to hold these stupid things in. Okay. Door. Ah, locked door. Scroll that I just threw. Door. I think we shall head this way. Oh god. I hate man scorpions.
Die by my blade, mortal.
So glad that I prepped negate poison. Negate poison, neutralize poison. Swell's getting the holy hell beaten out of him. Okay, these guys aren't nearly as tough as the ones that we fought out in the desert. Well, the one that we fought out in the desert that pretty thoroughly kicked half the party's ass at the time.
Die by my blade, mortal!
Ah. Okay, she needs to be cured of poison more or less immediately, otherwise she's gonna get killed. And then she can heal Swell. And then Swell will lay on hands her. There. Okay. Back to X. Oh god.
Die by my blade, mortal!
Die by my blade, mortal! Okay, there's a button in a long hall. Man, this is just like... this hallway worries me. Okay, we'll try this. Okay, can't press that. Then we'll try this button. Now, perhaps? No. Okay. Harakiri light armor. Armor bonus 6. Holy crap! That shit's powerful! We'll give it to Swell and then give Goldleaf the bandit mail. Or the plate mail. Damn! Note to self, the Harakiri make nice armor. Sleepy time. And we'll save. Oh, we have a button here. Did that unlock it? Haha! Oh yeah!
Die by my blade, mortal!
Damn it. So much poisoning. Improve. Even if I'd have known that we weren't going to be able to find any mages in this, I still wouldn't have added one to the party, just so that we could continue the story of Gold Moon and Swell. Okay, we have a portal that likely leads into some form of horrific trap. Where are you? Hey, bros! Damn it. And Swell's all, I like the potion, but the poison don't like me. Sling of Seeking? These are actually pretty good. Downside being that our cleric is a frontline fighter. So I wonder if instead, aw, we can't put useful things in the sling pouch. So yeah, that's gonna be a no-go. Alright, it's looking like this portal is the way to go. And we've neutralized poison and we're gonna sleep. Yes. We're going to Flame Blade. And we're going to save. It seems like I'm saving a lot. That's because I am. Okay. No horror story, I'm surprised. What do we got? Hold monster. I don't even know why I bother checking anymore. Ah. There are just a friggin' mountain of you guys in here, aren't there? Oh yeah. That one's actually making its way down here. Come on. Come on. I'm gonna get you.
Die by my blade, mortal.
You got some hit points on you. Oh, that's because I wasn't hitting you. Okay. Seriously, bro, die. Seriously. I don't think I was even hitting this one. There we go. I probably killed like these three or four of them over here. Yeah. Oh, a random targeting system. You confuse me sometimes. What do we got? Ooh, another key ring. That is minorly useful, but I suppose we will hold on to it. I suppose. What do we got over here? A Kopesh. Is it magical? Yes, no, maybe. Yes! Let's see, 2d8, 2d7, 2d8, 1d6. Wonder if it's better than the broadsword. We'll use it for a little while and see how it rolls. And how Swell doing on the hit points. 22, drop a lay on hands on him. And we will have her neutralize her poison. Okay. That hits pretty hard, I'll give it that. And a silver axe key. Damn it. And, ooh, a chest! Yay! More loot storage. Potion of speed, healing. We'll hold on to the potion of healing or speed. These we'll ditch. These we'll drop into inventory. And this is going to be our teleport holder thing. And she can carry it. No, she can't. Seriously, lady. Swell, looks like you're doing more carrying. Damn it. There. Okay, so we have crappy potions of healing, our scrolls, Swell's sharp object of awesomeness. Alright. Portal! Okay. So I think we're gonna GTL out of here. Actually, I would almost take this sling just so that we can kite things with it, but I really don't want to bother with picking up ammo after fights, so we're not going to. And we'll check out this area over here. Okay then. Pretty sure I got the key to that door. So the downside of the Kopesh is that it's pretty, it's slower than my broadsword was, but I think it does more damage. Oh my gosh. Jesus Christ, they are like Butcher and Goldleaf.
Die!
We got two of them on us, don't we? No. Okay. Neutralize spells poison. We will save. And I am going to call it an episode here because we just hit the half hour mark. So as per usual, thank you for watching and I will see you folks next time.